Slide 1. Dear Chairman, dear colleagues and guests. I am an automatic text reader, and I will present to your attention the work entitled Automated Recognition and Sorting of Recycled Textiles for Sustainable Fashion with authors Zlatin Zlatev and Julieta Ilieva. Slide 2. The growth of retail trade and fast fashion leads to a constant increase in the amount of waste from textiles. One solution to this problem is to use the principles of sustainable fashion. These principles are used at all stages of the product life cycle. From the delivery of materials and the production of textiles, to its reaching the end user. Also, the recycling and reuse of textiles. The active recycling and reuse of textile and fashion waste allows both designers and consumers to use waste as a resource. The principle of reuse is presented in a schematic form in the figure. The produced textiles are used in design and fashion. Once disposed of by consumers, textile waste is identified by an appropriate automated system and sorted. Sorted textile materials are returned for recycling in textile production. The cycle repeats. Slide 3. The identification of the types of fibers used in textile fabrics is important when sorting them for recycling. The fibers used in textile production can be both from natural sources and artificially created, as well as a combination of them. It is possible to sort the textile materials manually, depending on the fibers used. In this case, label data is used. In some cases, the label may be missing or may not contain information on the textile fibers used. Classical laboratory methods for determining what fibers are used in textile fabrics include dissolution, morphological differences, differential colorimetry, thermogravimetry, gas chromatography. Laboratory methods offer sufficient accuracy, but have the main disadvantage that they are time-consuming, sample preparation is required. They are not suitable for use in automated systems for sorting and recycling textile products. In automated systems, optical methods such as microscopic, image recognition in digital images, spectral, multispectral and hyperspectral methods are more commonly used for recognition. The use of digital imaging methods has the main disadvantage that the accuracy of textile fiber recognition is significantly influenced by the fabric dyes used. In spectral methods, the staining of textile fabrics does not significantly affect the recognition accuracy. In some cases, densely applied colorant, as well as darker colors, to some extent affect this recognition. Slide 4. The aim of this study is to make a more in-depth analysis of the known methods and approaches, using the techniques of spectral analysis, which will lead to improvement and facilitation of the process of classification of textile fibers in sorting and recycling of textile fabrics. In order to implement in automated systems. Slide 5. Textile fabrics containing cotton, polyester, elastin, polyamide and various combinations between them are used. The figure shows in general form samples of the fabrics used. Slide 6. Microscopic analysis of the textile fabrics was performed. For this purpose, an experimental setup shown in the figure was used. The following figure shows microscopic images of samples from different fibers. They are used in the identification of fibers in textile fabrics. Slide 7. The spectral characteristics of textile fabrics in the range 390 to 780 nanometers were obtained. A total of 11 spectral features were calculated from the spectral characteristics using the formulas presented on the screen. Slide 8. A statistically significant difference was found for fabrics with the same fibers but different colors. Three methods were used to select features. The resulting feature vectors are reduced with principal components and latent variables. Three classification procedures were used. The Bayesian classifier was used as a reference. Basic, actual, and total errors were used to evaluate the performance of the classifiers. Slide 9. It was found that there is no statistically significant difference between fabrics with the same fibers but different colors. Five groups of samples are defined with cotton, polyester, elastin, polyamide, and combinations between them. 100 spectral characteristics are obtained for every group of samples. Slide 10. a selection of informative features has been made. Those features that have weight coefficients with a value above 0.6 are selected. The selected feature vectors are presented in the table. The feature vector FV1 consists of a total of 6 features. FV2 has 5 features. Most features are selected in FV3, a total of 8 of them. Slide 11. The required number of principal components and latent variables to which the data in the feature vectors can be reduced are determined. The figure shows the result of this analysis. 2 principal components and 2 latent variables are sufficient to describe more than 95% of the variance in the data. The experimental data from the feature vectors used for classification have been reduced to such an extent. Slide 12. The results of classification with a naive Bayesian classifier show that the lowest error values are obtained by reducing the data volume of the feature vectors FV2 and FV3, with principal components. In other cases, the errors significantly exceed 10%. For the following analyses, a feature vector FV2, reduced by the principal components method, was chosen because the use of these data resulted in errors of less than 5% for all cases of textile fiber classification. Slide 13. When using the KNN method, significantly higher values of the main classification error are observed. This shows that the data from the first class fall incorrectly into the second one. Between classes S3 and S4 there is an increase in the actual error, which indicates that class 1 includes data from the second class. Although the total classification error is 0%, the use of KNN for the classification of textile fibers is inappropriate because more than 10% of the data are misclassified and do not fall into the relevant class to which they belong. When using discriminate analysis, regardless of the type of the separation function, uniform classification errors of up to 10% are obtained. The obtained results show that the accuracy of classification depends on the features used in the vector, the method for reducing the volume of data, as well as the type of classifier. The accuracy of classification does not depend on the type of separation function. Slide 14. The results obtained in the present work complement those of the available literature. In the present work, spectral characteristics in the visible region of the spectrum are applied. This increases the potential for mass use of spectrophotometric techniques in the sorting of textile materials. The question of the recognition of textile fibers when they are dyed with a dense and dark colored dye remains open. The application of spectrophotometric techniques, regardless of the spectral range, is not sufficiently effective. One solution to this problem would be the joint use of spectrophotometric and other types of sensors such as inductive, capacitive, ultrasonic. Slide 15. As a conclusion, it can be said that in the present work, an analysis of known methods and approaches applied so far using the techniques of spectral analysis. The proposed methods and procedures lead to improvement and facilitation of the process of classification of textile fibers in sorting and recycling of textile fabrics, in order to implement in automated systems. The proposed analysis tools do not require high-cost equipment and complex calculation procedures. They can be implemented in portable devices and microprocessor-based recognition systems. It has been found that 2 principal components and 2 latent variables are sufficient to describe more than 95% of the variance in the data. This significantly reduces the amount of data used to analyze textile fibers by their spectral characteristics. It has been shown that the accuracy of textile fiber classification does not depend on the type of separation function of the classifier used. This accuracy depends on the spectral characteristics used, the method for reducing the volume of data, and the type of classifier. The obtained results can be used in the development of recognition systems for sorting textile fabrics depending on the composition of their fibers. In this way, the principles of sustainable fashion will be effectively applied. Also, the proposed methods and tools can be used in the training of future specialists in the subject area. Slide 16. The authors would like to express appreciation for the co-funding of the Erasmus Plus program of the European Union, Project Fashion Diet. Thank you for your attention.